You're watching the Common Constitutionalist Weekend Video Podcast.
Hi there, my name is Brent Smith and I'm the Common Constitutionalist, and welcome back to another edition of the Weekend Common Constitutionalist Video Podcast. Today, frankly, I don't know if you're going to believe this topic because I frankly didn't believe it either. Evidently, black Americans aren't getting enough rest and they require sleep reparations. You heard that right, bro. Sleep reparations now. Just when you thought you've heard it all, right? So that's what we'll be discussing today, or I'll be discussing. You'll be watching and listening right after this. Be right back. Okay, I've entitled this podcast, "It's White Privilege to Get a Good Night's Sleep." You think that's ridiculous? You think I'm kidding? I'm not. this comes to us from Vice. Vice is about as leftist as you can possibly get, all right? This is the title of the actual serious article, what they... They think to be serious. It's not tongue-in-cheek. It's not satire. This is 100% serious. Entitled, "Reparations for Black People Should Include Rest." Unless you think that this is something new, it's not. This article was from January of 2019, and I found stuff dating back to 2015 where they were talking about reparations for sleep. I mean, I don't know. So anyway, and here's the subtitle from the article, "Reparations for Black People Should Include Rest." Just as sleep deprivation was used as a means to control slaves, here we go, the modern day sleep gap, there's a sleep gap now, there's a wage gap, there's an equality gap, there's every kind of gap in the world that they've created. They just keep trying to create more gaps and whatnot to separate us all. The modern day sleep gap weighs down many black people today. Does it really? I swear to God, I wish this was satire. I wish this was all a big joke, but it ain't. Here we go. This piece, or she writes, this Janine somebody, I can't remember, in Vice, or for Vice. This piece is a part of an issue of Black Power. Listen to this. This piece is a part of an issue of Black Power Naps magazine, as in Nappy Time magazine. So there's a magazine called Black Power Naps. Really? Created as a collaboration between Broadly, whatever, and artists Nib Acosta and Fanny Sosa. Woohoo! Which aims to interrogate racial equity and promote rest and healing among black people. Remember, this isn't satire. This is for reals, yo. A growing amount of research has found that black Americans experience significantly less slow wave sleep, the kind required for actual rejuvenating rest, than white Americans. So us white Americans are getting our slow wave sleep. And black Americans evidently aren't. She continues. Benjamin Rice pointed out in the LA Times back in 2017, now it goes back, we're going back 3 years now, black Americans have lacked access, the opportunity to get sleep. I don't know. Black Americans have lacked access to sufficient sleeping environments since slavery. Are we ever going to get over slavery? Answer, Not as long as they can make money and trouble for the rest of us. No. Particularly money. Okay, where was I? Okay, quote, aboard the ships of the transatlantic slave trade. It's like yesterday. I remember seeing one come into Boston Harbor. A slave ship, like yesterday, right? Come on. Aboard the ships of transatlantic slave trade, African captives were made to sleep en masse in the hold, often while chained together. Yes, and that's there. It's still going on today, apparently. Just as sleep deprivation was used as a means to control slaves, the modern-day sleep gap continues to weigh down many black people like me today. Now listen to this. Just listen to this. You be the judge how pathetic this is. I can feel it in me, Janine writes. It breaks my spirit. I exist in between, as I exist in between half-conscious states. Holy crap, is she on LSD or some freaking thing? What? Never fully awake or asleep, never able to distinguish between the two. Lady, you got some serious problems. Maybe you got sleep apnea, okay? Maybe it doesn't have anything to do with slavery. Maybe you're not, I don't even know if you're a descendant of slaves. You may not be. I don't know. This may, but you know, frankly, it doesn't make any difference because no, this is just ticking me off. This may be this may be the true power of racism. Its force encompasses everything, seeping into our dreams. You dream about slavery at night and deflating our capacity to envision a better future. While you've enslaved yourself pretty well, I'll tell you, because I know I haven't enslaved you, nor has any other white person in America. How can the radical black imagination this is serious, people. Come on. How can the radical black imagination rebel against a system that so thoroughly seeks to destroy us? That you found us out. We're depriving you of sleep to destroy the black race. Indeed. What would a future look like where we are liberated? Reparations are paid, and we can finally have a little nappy time. That's not what you said. She said, you can finally have a rest. I put in a little nappy time. Because apparently that's all they need is a nap. So this article, which is painfully and laboriously long, average article for most websites is between, say, 400 and 750 words. This is double or triple that. It was, like I said, laborious to say the least. It was painful, and I found myself barely being able to finish it, and I feel all the dumber for doing so. Pretty simple, okay? I just feel dumber. You know, alcohol and drugs are supposed to kill brain cells. That's what they do, right? But I think this article killed about as many brain cells in my head as like a month-long vodka-fueled rage. Just saying. So, time. Now, this is she, Janine, with her brilliance once again. You ready? You ready? This is a new one. Not heard this one before. Time as we know it is a colonial invention and forms the backbone of American society, making the racial distribution of time inherent to white privilege. So now time is what is endemic of white privilege. What the hell do you even say to something like that? I mean, this is the dumbest sentence I've ever heard. You know, you can't take a nappy time because you're oppressed, okay? You need reparations because you're oppressed. But now, time is a colonial invention? Really? By inviting black people to stop and rest, a little nappy time, black power naps, still care. I must have had let my subscription lapse because I checked my mail and this month's black naps monthly didn't come in. What are you going to do? So now I'm awake at night, wondering where my Black Power Naps magazine is. Don't know. By inviting people to stop and rest, Black Power Naps begins to let us reclaim our time. How are you going to do that? Does Black Power Naps magazine, did they invent it, time travel or something? Is this some sort of, you know, time warp or something? Did they invent that Star Trek type of deal? What? It restores our capacity to dream as Black people. And have you been dreaming as a Chinese person or something all this time, or a white, what? To imagine a future of Black rest, relaxation, and idleness. So you need to reclaim time. We need to pay you to get some rest, relaxation, and to be idle. Is that what you're looking for? You're looking for reparations, you're looking for money and time so you can be idle. Does that mean to sit on your butt and do nothing? As far as I know, idleness, that's what it means, okay? And lastly, not once in this long and painful article anywhere did it mention of what reparations would look like, okay? Is it money? Is it land? Is it like a lifetime supply of Z-Quil or melatonin sleep aid? Is it every Black person of color in America gets a Sleep Number bed and a My Pillow? What is it? Give me a number. Give me something concrete. Not thing. Nothing. Okay? This is all just what if bullcrap. It's like the 1619 projects. It's not history. They admit that it's a what if pigs could fly type of thing. Then we'd have bacon delivered to our house. I don't know. Whatever. I mean, I'm not trying to mock that. No, I am trying to mock this whole premise because it's so inanely stupid. I can't even stand it. Time is white privilege. We invented time as a colonial invention. And it's a white construct. Time is now a colonial invention. The first timepiece, like a sundial or whatnot, was discovered, I think it was like 3,500 years old in Egypt. I hate to break the news to you, Janine, but there was no freaking whitey white people in Egypt 3,500 years ago, and there ain't many of them now. Incas had pillars where they were able to tell time, tell the seasons of the four seasons of the calendar. They made the calendar, astronomy, the whole freaking thing. Advanced society, relatively speaking, the Incas. There wasn't one. At the time that they invented all this crap, not a single whitey white person had ever been seen in Inca territory in South America, Central America, the Mayans, or any of that stuff. Time is a white construct. You guys are just, it's just incredible. Where do you go with something like this? Just saying. I'd like to say some stuff. I'm going to hold my tongue and try to be civil about this. But this is just, of all the stupid things you Black activists have come up with, this takes the cake. Okay? You can't get any rest because you're oppressed Black, yet you're writing for a national news service, Vice. It's radical lefty, but it's still all, you can get it anywhere in the world. You can get her article. We have Black congressmen. We have Black senators. We have Black business titans. Okay, we had a Black president. We are the only, name to me, Miss Janine, name to me another majority white nation on earth in history that's ever voted in a Black president or prime minister. Name one. You know why you can't? Because there hasn't been. That's why we are as progressive as it gets as far as race is concerned, and you people are just full of crap. You got nothing else to bitch about, okay? So this is what you invent, that time is a whitey white construct. We invented time. What are you freaking kidding me? And that you can't nap and you dream about slavery every night? Boy, the education system really excelled on you. It really excelled with you, didn't it? Where do we even go from here? I don't know. I mean, what are you going to do with somebody like this? I don't know that she's a lost soul. I don't know that she could be brought back from the abyss, to be honest with you. A lot of people can. There are a lot of reasonable Democrats and liberals that have been brought out into the light, so to speak, and see what the radical left is really all about. And yet, I still have not heard of any of you radicals saying, this is how much you owe us. You owe each and every person of color X, okay, and that's going to take care of it. You know why? Because if you ever got X, you wouldn't have anything to bitch about, and then what would you make up then? I don't know. Air is a white construct? Is that what it is? I don't know. So my name is Brent Smith. I'm the common constitutionalist. And I guess that's it. I'm going to go take a nap. See ya.